As you probably already know, an automated teller machine, ATM, is an electronic telecommunications device that enables customers of financial institutions perform financial transactions on their own. Such transactions include cash withdrawals and deposits, funds transfer, or obtaining of account information at any time and without the need for direct interaction with bank staff. Among some of the benefits of an ATM are the fact that cash can be withdrawn at any bank. The ATM card is protected by a PIN to ensure safeguarding of the customer's money. In fact, the introduction of the ATM revolutionized banking in Nigeria. But despite the benefits, the ATMs in Nigeria, established more than two decades ago, still seem to have many challenges. Bank customers are complaining daily. Are their complaints genuine and justified? Are there solutions in sight? That's our focus on Nigeria today, this Wednesday. Thank you for joining us. My name is Kande Daniel. Welcome back. I have two guests on the program to talk about the challenges that Nigerians are facing in using the automated teller machine, otherwise known as ATM. Obinnaya Uruakpa, a former financial service executive and entrepreneur, is seated to my far left in yellow.
My pleasure.
You're welcome to Nigeria Today.
Thank you.
Yusha Aliyu, an economic analyst, is also part of this half-hour discussion.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you for coming on the program. I can imagine many Nigerians, with the introduction we just gave, you know, saying, great, talk about ATM. We hope you answer all the questions we have in our minds. I want to assure them you will do just that. Welcome again to the program. Obinnaya Uruakpa, I want to begin with you. Has the ATM technology, to your mind, after so many years, served the purpose or purposes for which it was introduced into the country?
Thank you for that question. You're not going to get a yes or no answer from me. But I'll tell you that within the ambit of the challenges we have as a nation, our level of development as a developing nation, the ATM has done the much it can do with the infrastructural challenges you have in this country. Remember that the ATM depends on certain infrastructural foundations. You're talking about technology, you're talking about the internet.
And okay, before you go into, I think you're beginning to tell us The problems that lead to the problems that we're having with the ATM right now. Before we get onto that, let's have Yusha, the economic analyst, give us his thoughts as to the nature of complaints that you have heard, you know, around town.
It's not complaint around town, but complaint about users, including myself. ATM, any potential customer of a bank who is mobilizing resources to the bank is bound to have an ATM card based on his own choice. So that choice has to do with a lot of consequences. That is the consequences we are now facing. There are so much complaint. ATM as a card or as a debit card in Nigeria is serving a purpose that if a cashless society is to move forward, there is need to be to have an efficient system. The complaint is about inefficiency and overcharges. These are the basic complaint. And a situation where you have charges that are coming in multiplicity and coming from different direction, and service that is always inefficient, you begin to find why must we continue to advance for those that are financially literate? How do they cope with the situation? And even those that are financially deficient in what it takes to use money. Because before you even enjoy ATM, you must understand why there is money in an economy. Why you must have money around you, either in your pocket or outside your pocket. Because the definition of money, the importance of money goes beyond keeping money, but using money when you are seeing it and even when you are not seeing it.
Okay. Mr. Rabu, quickly, in a few words, do you agree that those are the problems, the complaints that you have heard from users in the industry?
Totally.
Inefficiency, overcharges, are there any other problems? Quickly?
Totally, there are many other problems. He touched a little bit, financial literacy. You need to understand the level of education in our society. We have had situations where people have inadvertently compromised their card details, their PIN number, because they do not understand or have not been tutored on the usage of the ATM. So sometimes they tell the nearest person their PIN number, which you're not supposed to disclose. And you leave that at the doorsteps of those who manage the financial services industry, maybe the fiscal policy makers, and then of course the money market operators. So you cannot divorce that from the problems that people face out there. Now, if you also look at the society, like I began to say, the infrastructure challenges we have, you have energy problems and so on. The other problem you may begin to say is if we're not careful, we think that it's a problem that is that of the users. You also have challenges that the operators have. The average ATM machine costs between $8,000 and $100,000.
Let's talk about that now, because more of the focus, because the citizens, the customers, of course, are a larger population than the bankers themselves. So we hear, you know, more loudly the complaints of the challenges the users are facing.
Yes.
Right. So you're already talking about the challenges that bankers or banks face in providing ATM services.
Yeah, a lot. Mm-hmm. A lot. From my experience coming from that sector, and I'm not holding brief for them, I can tell you authoritatively that you have to provide security for every ATM infrastructure you put up. And then you have to also get, apart from providing security around it, you have to provide even human security. Beyond that, you have to invest in technology. You have to invest in the internet, and it doesn't cost anything cheap. And when you now want to spread the cost, at some point, the CBN governor asked them to remove all costs. And even today, when you use the card of the bank that you use, it's free. It's only when you use the card on that of another bank, you get charged 65 naira. For each usage, for each withdrawal. Now, the banks also need to recover the $100,000, sometimes $50,000 that one machine costs. And then you talk about exchange rates and all of that. So I sympathize with them. Mm-hmm. And then in an environment where sometimes you want to put a machine in a facility, you have to also pay rent for mounting it in a shopping plaza or in some community. That's if you're not dealing with community relations issues. So we need to begin to look at it holistically. As a nation, do we have an enabling environment to operate a cashless society? And then that comes down to the doorsteps of the Central Bank of Nigeria that try to institute a cashless policy. We need to go into education. We need to go into security. It's an all-encompassing thing. It's not going to be put at the doorstep of just only the users or the operators are facing challenges, and even you and I in every sector of the economy also need to get involved to get it resolved.
You agree that the complaints of the users are genuine?
Of course, yes.
And also have serious constraints or challenges facing operators. Do you have anything more to add to that?
I don't have to. You know, when bank is mentioned, bank is an investment. And when you look at what they declare annually in terms of profit, so we cannot just say we put emphasis on the cost of ATM machines, because these are services which the banks must render to its customer, because they have a wider coverage or leverage of using the resources of that same customer to invest in different fields as allowed by law. So the constraint Mr. Obinna raised has a solution, because it's propitiating. These banks are declaring profit.
Sure.
But what we are asking is a situation where this bank should be efficient. multiple charges, which is a complaint that normally attracts so much pain from the customers, has to be looked into. Remember, the 65 naira charges was introduced in 2014, and since then you find a situation where the banks took advantage of the charges and they limit the cash availability in the machines so as to exploit. And the essence of level playing ground is to control the excesses from the users and excesses from the operators. Mind you, there is relativity. There must be a regulatory agency. There must be operators. There must be customers. But who is the king among them? The king is the customer. Because any time an economy is moving forward, it has to mobilize resources from all within. Yeah. Because these resources, these monies that are going around within the economy are produced at a cost. And for us to have the resources together, the banks know carefully how they raise, how they create money. As an experienced banker, he is aware that banks create money. So by creating money, they have to also create happiness as a social cost. In my own opinion, of course, there are constraints faced by them. Yeah. But what came out of all this is that there is an attempt to exploit situation. Somebody that has 100,000 naira in his account and want to use 40,000 naira, and you go to a bank where the debit card was issued, and the bank will refuse. Your financial system is out of service. But when you go to the next bank because of 65 naira, what you are going to face, withdrawal limit of 5,000 naira per transaction. So 65 naira is going to be divided into four. If you are charging for 20,000, and remember, let us go by small statistics. 65,000 naira, how many bank customers? More than 43 million bank customers. Assuming only 10 million are ready to use ATM card, and they are to use ATM card only for 3 hours in a day, you times the chain and the gains of that 65. One transaction for 10 million customers is 650 million. So the cost of automatic teller machine that is cost 50,000 naira is going to be resolved with a transaction of a day. But where is the efficiency?
Mr. Rock, I can see you're smiling, which means our economic analyst is analyzing appropriately.
Awesome.
And you know, what I understand from him, part of what I understand is that banks are actually making big business from the ATMs while the customers complain. Otherwise, if they were not making big business, it wouldn't be continuing. The machines are still there, and more and more, I believe, are coming.
Yeah.
What would you say in response to what the analyst has said concerning the quality of services, you know, that the banks are providing via the ATMs and the possibility of improving? Also, what defense does the customer have? Is the customer completely at the mercy of the operator?
Yeah, someone said, what never gets measured never gets done. Regulation is key. My challenge is, can we authoritatively say that the Banking Supervision Department of the Central Bank of Nigeria has all it takes to monitor the over 24 banks that are still standing, commercial banks that are still standing?
Do you think it does?
I don't think so. And I'm going to be very blunt with you. Do they have enough staff to go around monitoring them? One bank has over how many branches? But let's drop that. Where I have a challenge with the average business person in Nigeria is the type of business model we adopt. What have you got to lose if you mount as many ATMs as possible, as many machines as possible? If you know that there is a high traffic in Okare market, or in Ariaria market, or in the Federal Secretariat, why don't you mount 100 machines?
It's an investment.
It's an investment. And if you know you want to do this business, do it well. Go the whole hog. get investors, get all of us to invest. We all, many of us bought shares and we're wondering how much dividends we're getting from there. So that you understand that it's not like I'm holding forth. My very first sentence, I'm not holding forth for any party. Yeah. I'm just trying to be as objective as possible. And that I believe Yoshua is also doing. Mm-hmm. So I believe strongly that if you want to do this business, financial services, go the whole hog. Get investors from wherever. You can't be declaring profits like you said and not reinvesting in the economy. And reinvesting in the economy means that you understand all the whole aspects of the business you're doing to satisfy the customer, because like you said, the customer is not just king, the customer is God. With a small g.
Small g God.
The customer is God. And if the customer, I had a chat, knowing I was coming on this show, I had a chat with a staff of one of the institutions here. And she told me the experience she had with one of the banks. She put in her machine, and it didn't pay her. She went to another machine, with her card into a machine, and it didn't pay her. Went to another machine, it paid her. And then it was counted for her that she had withdrawn from this other one. And then she tried resolving it, and then obviously it became clear to me that there was a customer service faux pas instantly. Whoever the staff she met was, and whoever the head office people were, did not satisfy this customer. And she closed her account, got her colleagues in the office to close the account. And the bank she mentioned is one of the banks that is facing challenges today. So we need to also understand that this thing touches everybody. And we're talking about the economy, really. Because like you said, if the money is, as I speak to you, there's more money outside the banking system than inside the banking system. And the challenge we have is that if we can gain the confidence, someone said if you get the heart of the people, then you can ask for their hands. If you get the heart of the average Nigerian, the National Population Commission man just reported that in New York that we're 198 million now. Meaning that if you have 100, he just using 10 million to calculate, 198 million, just do the 80-20 rule, the Pareto principle, 20% of that population, and let them do ATM. The banks make money, the economy makes money, FIRS gets to make money, you and I make more money, and then we can invest in different infrastructures in the site, and then we can resolve all the problems.
Okay, well, I'll stop you right there. We'll continue in a moment, because right now we are breaking off to go to the streets to take responses from some Nigerians on their experiences while trying to benefit from the ATM system.
Those of us that stays in Nanya,
all right, we'll have a little hitch there. I hope our engineers can still get that tape rolling, because it would help us with this discussion, knowing what the people themselves will have to say. Because sitting out there, they're looking at you and I as upper class, talking from up there. Okay, let's give it another try.
Those of us that stays in Nanya of the town, the most of the challenges we do have using ATM is, especially basically during weekend, we do have network challenges, which is very bad, which is not supposed to.
Sometimes the challenge is maybe if I go to withdraw money, the money will not pay me, but it will debit me. So I keep on complaining, but if you go to the bank, they'll tell you that you should wait for 24 hours. But sometimes if you go, the money, I have one experience that like that up to now I've lost the money.
Ordinarily, since I cannot go to the counter anymore, I'm supposed to get to the ATM machine, pick my money and go. But I can tell you, nowadays, the ATM has become an ordinary mug. When you get to the ATM, you find that many people are queuing, the money is not there, people are hissing, and the place is quite uncomfortable.
Well, more and more complaints. Still in Nigeria today. My guests, the financial service executive Obinna Orakwa and the economic analyst Yushau Aliyu are still here, and we continue with the discussion, taking a cue from the vox pop we just watched. Do you get any angle, any new angle?
There are many angles, because when you mention debiting, it's constant. Every ATM user is a victim of that. It will debit you. Sometimes it will take 2 days, sometimes 3 months. There was a time personally, over 7 months, in a different city.
But these days, I know there's a slight improvement, some sort of improvement. There are instant reversals these days.
Yes.
But there's still some of the inefficiency.
It is a problem. No matter what, you are not supposed, a customer that is banking with you, who has a target with the available resources, need his cash immediately. Because Hicksian analysis postulate that a consumer, using indifferent curve analysis, a consumer is indifferent. No matter what, if you put your debit card and it's a debited, you are frustrated. Because you are going with time, you are going with your program, you are going with emotional disturbances. That emotional disturbances causes a lot of problem. You see at ATM centers, people crying. Even though it's going to be reversed. But that is not the question. What I want to hit about this ATM and the business of ATM, it has gone beyond banks. We have to also go back to the monetary authorities.
That's true, sir.
How much is produced and then supplied to an economy? And what type of currency is supplied? The type of mutilated papers, currencies, that we have today cannot continue to allow the ATMs to work. Because the denotes invariably are so important. Because they have a multiplier in their own chain of activity. Every 500 naira produced is expected to have 4,000 points of transaction. Every note. So, but in a situation, you have mutilated currencies supplied to banks. Banks are now in a very difficult situation. Now, this is currency supply from CBN, then bank to the bank, then who misuse the currencies? We, the end users. Our attitude to our currency is not patriotic. You find, you go to market, you see how people, you see Okadibu squeezing money, giving you change with a squeezed money. And it pains me more when squeezed money is given to a law enforcement agency. And the same enforcement agencies, in some cases, squeeze the same
money into
different levels. So the challenges are so great. But what is the next line of action? The next line of action is the monetary authority. Because where there is law, there is regulation, and there is control. And we're supposed to at least go by it. Money supply, M1, M2, how much is produced? And you look at the economies, is it how much is required to be in Lagos? It's not going to be the same with the amount of money that will be in Zamfara State.
True.
So, but what type of businesses also going on there? The bank has to make studies. Studies are there. Bureau of Statistics has a role to play to understand the nature of businesses, especially on market days.
Okay, related to this issue of money supply, I know you're itching to say something.
Yeah.
Give me an insight on this before you say what you want to say. Related to this issue of fake notes, I have heard, I don't know whether you have heard, about fake notes coming out of ATMs.
It still comes down to efficiency, operational efficiency. And it's operations management right there. Anyone would tell you that in every bank, you have your internal audit. You have all of the different structures have been put in place to ensure that operation is seamless. So that at the point of service, serving the customer, you don't get to see what happens in the back end. You just have a wild customer that is happy with the service. But a lot of things go on in the background. Now, every bank needs to bring out their A game to ensure that all of the things he has said are put in place. Now, but it doesn't stop with just the banks. It comes down to the monetary authorities. It comes down to the quality of money supplied. And talking about quality of money supplied, it also goes beyond that to go back to NOA. He mentioned the Bureau of Statistics.
Yes.
Yeah, NOA, NTA, and all of the institutions that have to do the media. And I've seen that a lot on NTA, where you try to enlighten people. It comes down to community-based organizations, comes down to traditional rulers, trying to explain to people that money, it costs money to print money. Sometimes it costs a lot to bring out a note, a 10 naira note. And if care is not taken, we are the ones that face the reality down. The Consumer Protection Council needs to get involved in monitoring what happens to consumers and the customers of banks. In the cause of talking about the debiting and reversal, it could be a medical emergency. Why would you take 24 hours to reverse my money? Mm-hmm. Now, when you sack tellers in the bank, and because you have introduced ATM, do you have a guarantee or do you have a plan B in case the technology fails? Because it will, okay. Anything technology can fail.
We've actually run out of time. Okay. I'll give you a time to give us in one sentence each, by way of seeking solution. What do you suggest as solutions to these challenges?
I think we need to bring ourselves to a round table, bring the security apparatus into it, bring the media apparatus into it, bring the regulators, bring the operators to a round table. Maybe you actually need to have a conference on this. Mm-hmm. The people on the streets have a right to comment on this. You cannot have a queue in Nnewi or in Obuza market on a weekend when people need to take money to go for traditional wedding and mm-hmm. so on. You cannot afford that. If you continue to do that, you will not achieve the cashless economy.
Mm-hmm. You shall.
There is need for the monetary authority to look at the liquidity with these banks, because the cash crunch mostly appeared in all the banks that they are waiting for customers to have money in order to now put it back to the same. That is one. Two, there is need also for monetary authority to carefully look at the currency management, the amount of currency in circulation. CBN recently in 2016 moved so much of money from the economy. So there is need to look at the demand to match with the supply.
All right. Thank you, gentlemen. I must at this point thank you so much your time and for sharing your perspectives on this very important subject. Well, this is the end of the chat on Nigeria Today this Wednesday. My guests, Obinnaya Uruakpa, former financial service executive and entrepreneur, and Yushal Aliyu, an economic analyst, discussing the many challenges that Nigerians have been facing using the ATM for financial transactions. Thanks for being a part of it. And remember, you can watch the program online at www.youtube.com/NTANews24Hub. My name is Kande Daniel. Enjoy the rest of your evening.